Hi there, I'm James Preston, and thanks for tuning in to Calkine Media. In this segment, we're taking a look at what an IPO is and why a company would decide to go public. But before we get into it, please make sure to subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to be notified of the latest videos. Global equity markets witnessed a surge in the number of companies going public in 2021, despite concerns about the potential volatility from the resurgence of COVID-19 cases. In the first quarter of 2021, as many as 727 companies launched an initial public offering globally, commonly known as an IPO, and in turn raised a record $202.9 billion from the public listing of shares, which indicated that even a global pandemic couldn't diminish investors' appetites for hot new floats. The Australian IPO market also experienced a similar trend, with as many as 34 companies making their debut on the Australian Securities Exchange in the first 4 months of this year. The list includes some big names, such as telecoms and 5G provider Pentanet, Firebird Metal, Airtasker, Latitude Financial, Mighty King, Peter Warren Automotive, and others. This was attributed to strong macroeconomic indicators, which provided positive momentum to equity markets with a solid economic recovery narrative. A higher price trend in commodities led to a surge of IPOs by miners, including those with gold, silver, and copper assets, while government stimulus programs and post-pandemic optimism propelled healthcare and technology companies to go public as well. With so much capital being raised in this manner, many people think of IPOs as big money-making opportunities. So before investing in IPOs, investors must understand what exactly an IPO is. An IPO is a process to raise money through the public listing of shares on a new stock exchange. In an IPO, a private company issues shares for the first time to the public at a predetermined price or price band. The company sells shares to retail investors as well as institutional investors. The process allows investors to assess and maybe take exposure to the potential growth of a business. So why does a company decide to go public? Many companies consider IPO listing as a means to boost growth, create new opportunities for the business, and provide a liquid market for their securities. Besides, some companies plan overseas listings to access global markets, and private equity investors use IPOs to exit their investments. There are several reasons behind a company's decision to go public, but the primary objective is to raise funds and to attain a potential premium value to its assets, business model, and future growth. The company raises capital via an IPO to expand its business, scale up operations, create new products, or pay off existing debts. The IPO provides a financial cushion to companies to take risk. Besides, it's also a cheaper source of raising funds as compared to venture capitalists, private investors, or bank loans. Many companies go public to raise funds to minimize their debt loads. Companies that face credit crunch reduce their debt levels by using IPO fund proceeds. This also helps in minimizing their debt and financing charges. Paying off existing shareholders is also a motivation for some companies. In some cases, promoters or owners sell stakes to raise capital. Another motivation is that an IPO offers a liquidity path to firms as it allows private companies' owners to convert their ownership in the company to any other form of currency or investment. And quite commonly, companies will often go public in an attempt to finance their future projects through the IPO proceeds. It also provides a financial cushion to explore business expansion or a diversification plan. Those are the main reasons a company decides to go public, but why would an investor decide to get involved in an IPO? For investors, IPOs can be a window of opportunity to invest in high growth companies and earn dividends. An IPO provides an option to buy shares at attractive prices offered by different companies. IPOs may offer higher returns as companies generally issue share prices at a much lower price. Once listed, the share price may go up sharply. Companies with growth potential and strong fundamentals are likely to deliver higher returns post-listing. However, investors must understand that investments with high reward potential also carry a much higher risk. So, they should carefully evaluate the opportunity compared to the offering price of the securities. Not all IPOs end up becoming large cap companies. Therefore, it's essential to assess the associated risk. Another question to ask is, what is the process to launch an IPO? Going public is a daunting task for a private company, as the IPO process is complex and requires time, money, and substantial consulting. Not every company is fortunate enough to sail through an IPO process. And even after making it to the stock exchange bourse, there is no guarantee that the company will have share price growth over the future. The first step includes the appointment of an experienced team of advisors to manage the IPO. The next step involves the drafting of a prospectus, listing application and other required documents, and undertaking a due diligence process. The third step involves lodging the prospectus with the Australian Securities and Investment Commission, more commonly known as ASIC. In the fourth step, companies file a listing application with the ASX within 7 days of lodging the prospectus with ASIC. The regulator generally reviews and approves the application within 6 weeks. In the fifth step, the company launches an offer and commences marketing to retail investors. In the last step, the offer closes and shares are allocated to investors while the company gets listed on the ASX and trading commences. So if all of this is sounding interesting and you're keen to get in early, how can you track upcoming IPOs in Australia? For information on upcoming IPOs, investors should keep an eye on the ASX website to capitalize on available opportunities. Exchange websites are a widely preferred and easy way to track new offerings as well. Investors can also refer to other sources for information on upcoming offers, such as Google Alert, the Twitter handles of IPO buffs, financial publications, newspapers, and websites providing IPO-specific news and other secondary sources. If you've enjoyed the information contained in this video, then make sure to like, share, and comment on the video, and of course, subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to be notified of the latest videos. For more information and regular updates, you can always head across to the website calkindmedia.com. I'm James Preston for Calkind Media.